less stirring tales told of the sea, and also some fairly uninteresting ones, only marginally connected with it, like this one. Sorry, this isn't a very good announcement. Sorry.
And here is the result of the Where to Put Edward Heath statue competition. The winner was a Mr. Ivy North, who wins 10 guineas and a visit to the sailors' quarters. That was last year's reenactment of the Battle of Pearl Harbor, performed by the Batley Town Women's Guild. It was written, directed, and produced by Mrs. Rita Fairbanks.
Hello again.
And what are your ladies going to do for us this year?
Well, this year we decided to reenact something with a more modern flavor. We had considered a version of Michael Stewart's speech on Nigeria, and there were several votes on the committee for a staging of Herr Willy Brandt's visit to East Germany. But we settled instead for a dramatization of the first heart transplant. Incidentally, my sister Madge will be playing the plucky little Springbok pioneer, Dr. Christian Barnard.
Well, off we go then with the Batley Towns Women's Guild reenactment of the first heart transplant.
First heart transplant. But this is not the only open-air production here that has used the sea. Theatrical managers in this area have not been as slow to appreciate the sea's tremendous dramatic value. And somewhere out in this bay is the first underwater production of Measure for Measure.
Yes, he would give thee from this rank offense, spoke to offend him still. It's like the time that I can do what I ought to name, or else I'll die.
Thanks, dear Isabel.
Be ready to hear of your death tomorrow.
When you would force her. Sure, it is a sin. All of it.
The underwater version of Measure for Measure. And further out to sea, Hello Dolly is also doing good business. And over there on the oyster beds, Formula 2 car racing.